In this video, I'll be showing you how to install the PI interface for OPC DA, along with the PI interface configuration utility. Right now, we're logged on to our new PI interface node, which doesn't have any OSIsoft software on it yet. However, it does have the OPC server installed and running, and that's going to be my data source for my PI interface for OPC DA. Before we begin, we'll want to make sure that the user that's going to be performing this installation is either the local administrator or is a member of the local administrators group. So let's do that first. So I know that I'm using my domain account, so I'm going to check whether it's a member of the administrators group. And I can do this using the administrative tools. So in Windows 8, you can simply type it, and you'll be able to find it under settings. You can also find the administrative tools using the control panel. Okay, so now we want to click on Computer Management, and then go under Local Users and Groups, and select Groups. Here we'll be able to find the Administrators group. So let's double click on that, and we'll see the Administrators properties. So here we can see which user accounts are members of the Administrators group. So here I can see that my account is a member, so I'm good to go. Okay, so the first step is going to be to download the installation kits off the TechSupport website. The URL of the TechSupport website is techsupport.osisoft.com. The first thing to do is to sign in. In order to download the installation kits, you're going to need access to a single sign-on account, which is linked to a site which is licensed for the PI interface for OPC DA. Once I've signed in, I can access the Download Center by pressing the Downloads button here. The most commonly used downloads are available on the front page. And under PI Interfaces and PI Connectors, I have my PI Interface for OPC DA and my PI Interface Configuration Utility. I'll start by downloading the PI Interface for OPC DA. The installation kit is the very first link here. I need to make sure to select the appropriate license type. I also need to make sure to read the License and Services Agreement. Once I've done this, I can check the box and start the download. I'll want to save the download somewhere on the computer. So I've got a folder on my desktop for my installation kits, so I'll save it here. Once I've done this, I can go ahead and download the PI Interface Configuration Utility. So once again, I can hit Downloads and click on PI ICU. The installation kit download is going to be the very first link again. Once again, I need to select the appropriate license type. And once I've read the License and Services Agreement, hit the checkbox and start the download. Once the downloads have completed, I can browse to the location on my computer where I saved the installation kits. So now I can start my installations. So if you have an existing interface node, you might have already installed the PI ICU. So you can skip the next part and go straight to the PI interface for OPC DA installation. But I'm going to start with the PI ICU since I haven't installed it yet. So when you're running installation kits, an important step to remember is hit Shift and then right-click on your installation kit and select Run as Administrator. This will ensure that you have the proper permissions while running the installation kit. So here you can choose where to extract the executable. You can leave the default location, which will be a temporary location, or select another location on your computer. Since I've prepared a location, I'll select that location. Okay, so the first window shows me which components are going to be installed as part of the installation. For example, I see here that the PI Software Development Kit is going to be installed, and the PI Buffer Subsystem will be installed. Something that's important to remember here is that one of the components is the Microsoft .NET Framework 4. So this installation requires a reboot of the computer. So if you're not ready to reboot the computer, keep in mind that this will be required at some point. So I already have this component installed, so I don't need to worry. However, I do need to remember that some of these components may stop and restart the other OSIsoft software I might have already installed. So let's say you have other components, such as other interfaces running already, those might be stopped momentarily. That means that you're going to stop collecting data momentarily. So if this is not a good time for that, you might want to wait until you have some downtime to perform these installations. Since this is the very first OSIsoft software that I'm installing, I don't need to worry, so I'll just go ahead and click OK. Next, I'm told to choose my PI home directory. The default directory is the operating system directory C. So if you have a different drive where you would like to install OSIsoft software, make sure to specify it now, because this is going to decide all subsequent installations. Now we need to put in our default PI server. You'll want to choose the PI server, which is now known as the PI Data Archive, that you want to send your data to. So here we see the status of all the services that were created during the installation, and we see that all services were started successfully, so we can go ahead and hit Next. And in this window, we see that all the components were installed successfully. Okay, so now we're ready to install our PI interface for OPCDA. So again, we want to hit Shift, right-click, and select Run as Administrator. Once again, we can leave the default execution path or select one that we have chosen. Once again, here we can see the components that will be installed. Most of these components were installed when we installed the PI Interface Configuration Utility. So what remains are the components specific to the PI Interface for OPCDA. So here we can personalize our installation. And now we're installing the PI interface for OPCDA. You'll notice here that the same thing applies. Some existing PI services are going to be stopped during the installation. So again, make sure that you're doing this when it's okay to stop these components, such as PI interfaces. So you might want to wait until you have downtime for this installation. Alright, and now we can see that all the components were installed successfully. So perfect, now we're ready to start. And in the next video, I'll show you that the first step is going to be to check the data on our OPC server using the PI OPC client tool, which was installed with the PI interface for OPCDA.